Did you know that it's pretty simple to connect your iPad and your iPhone up to an electronic whiteboard? In this clip, part one, I'm going to show you three simple steps to do this. First, buy the right adapter. Now, I am no technician, so to make sure I bought the right adapter, I took a photo of the connection cords in each of the classrooms I teach in. Then I took that photo and my iPad into the shop and showed the guy there, and he found exactly the right adapter for me. The first adapter I bought was an adapter for VGA connections. Since I use an iPad 2 and iPhone 4, I needed this one. If you have a newer iPad or iPhone, you'll probably need a lightning adapter. However, last year, three of my classrooms had their projectors upgraded. This meant that I needed another type of adapter for an HDMI connection. So I bought this one as well. And yes, they are expensive. So be sure to put your name on your adapters just in case you leave it behind, which I have done a number of times. Step 2. Check out the electronic whiteboard speakers and sound connections. For new projectors with the HDMI connection, sound should come through the adapter and you just use the whiteboard remote to control the volume. For most VGA connections, there can be a number of different scenarios. There may be a little sound cord to plug into your iPad or iPhone. In one of my classes, the electronic whiteboard speakers don't work, so the classroom teacher bought her own speakers and I have to plug into that system. In another one of my classrooms, there are speakers alongside of the board, but it has a USB cord for them, but I can't use a USB cord with my devices. This brings me to step 3. Step 3. Buy a decent Bluetooth speaker. Now, technology can be so unreliable, so I try to eliminate as many variables as possible. Having my own Bluetooth speaker has been great. This is the one that I use, and it has a decent sound output that works in all 10 of my classrooms. Have a look here at my trolley. My little speaker is attached to the top handle, so this way I don't leave it behind. So there you have it. Three simple steps to connecting up your iPad or iPhone to electronic whiteboards. In my next video, part 2, technology, I will connect it all up and show you how it works in the classroom. And I also will be showing you which apps I use, and I'll show you how to get your video clips, PowerPoints, and music, and whatever you need to get up onto the whiteboard for your lessons. Be sure to subscribe if you want to keep up with the next part of this series. If you have any questions, just leave a comment below, and I hope this helps.